Hey there, Sharon Hornelson here. Welcome to day 2258 of What's You Up To Now, documenting the journey originally as I came online from the brick and mortar corporate world of business to the online world of business and the internet world and back and forth again in during the pandemic and after the pandemic and pretty much all the time I've been in both worlds now for the last since 2017. So today I create a couple of pieces of content every day and I'd like to share what they are. This is my spot to document my journey and summarize what's working, what's not working. And I realized today I went down a rabbit hole in the middle of making my videos and creating my content of looking at other people's things. Just, sometimes as you're doing things, you get stuck and then you get sucked into things. That is so common in the online world, in the digital marketing world, to get pulled into different directions, to simultaneously get pulled into different directions. So I shook myself off and said, okay, wait a minute, get back on track. You have another video to make. So today we're talking about, in this year's annual challenge, the Let's Grow Annual Challenge, physical growth and is our focus for this month. We're doing, every month I do an area of the life framework that I've been using. This one, since 2021, I added two parts to my life framework. I learned this life framework from Tony Robbins, who got it from Jim Rohn, who probably got it from another guru, who probably got it from Napoleon Hill or somebody. I don't know. Anyway, the personal development industry is very interrelated. And so you hear a lot of concepts over and over again from different people. And at some point, when you make them your own, you forget where you even discovered them in the first place. Because when you clicks again for the 100th time, you've probably been exposed to it 100 times by at least a dozen different sources. So I don't even know where some of the stuff that I do automatically has come from originally. But I do remember Tony Robbins had a seven-part framework, and I've used that one since the 1980s, so it's been a long time. But following the pandemic, when there were crazy times going on, I took some coaching in the area of confidence and communication. And I thought, if I'm doing this, I might as well share it with other people. So I added it to my life framework. And I think they're such foundational skills that I keep them in my life framework and try to continually improve in those areas. Although I think there are some things I could do to focus and improve my communication. And I'm in a course right now that it's like, in my face that I've known this stuff for at least a decade and I'm still not doing it. So like everybody else, sometimes we apply things right away. Sometimes it isn't our time to apply them. And when we're ready, when the student is ready, the teacher appears, etc. So today in the challenge, we're talking about physical thoughts and beliefs. And our assignment's super easy today. Just notice what your thoughts and beliefs about your physical growth and potential are right now, and then just jot them down. And at the end of the day, we're looking at that list and we're saying, are these for me positive and the growth in the direction I want to go, or are they not really supporting me in the direction I want to go? For example, I had that basically as I'm getting older, I'm getting fatter, less flexible, less energy, less healthy, et cetera. All of those are the ones that popped into my head first thing this morning. All of those are against where I want to go with respect to my physical well-being, health, and growth going forward, right, as I age. So over the course of this month, we'll figure out how are we going to combat those? How are we going to take those negative beliefs or those beliefs that aren't in my favor and change them to something that is in my favor? And so we'll do that through the rest of the month. But that was, I guess, we have these recordings that play in our mind over and over and over again at a subconscious level. And sometimes we just need to make ourselves aware of them so we can ask ourselves, does that still make sense for me? Do I want to believe that as I get older, I'm going to have less energy, I'm going to be slower, I'm going to be fat? No, that's not what I want for myself. I want to be healthier, more vibrant, have more energy so I can keep up with my grandkids. Talked about that yesterday, et cetera. So thoughts and beliefs today. And then for Supersize Your Business, I'm talking about upselling and cross-selling and the power that they have and different strategies that we can use to implement them in our business, in almost any business. And it's funny, we're talking about physical growth this month, and I forgot to give some physical examples when I was talking about it. Why? Because I start talking and I go off on little tangents every once in a while. Imagine that. So it's so mind-blowing because there's so many examples of physical cross-sells and upsells in our world. both in the online world. In the online world, look at anybody's funnel and you see upsells, cross-sells, a lot of them. Almost every funnel has them now. Why? Because they're so powerful in increasing our profitability. The same is true in the offline world. Have you been to Walmart and bought an electronic or Target or any Lowe's? You buy a drill, they sell you an extended warranty. If you buy anything, they offer you an upsell of an extended warranty. Houses, you buy real estate, home warranty or appliance warranties. Insurance is kind of like a warranty. Insurance or warranties are two of the most commonly offered upsells and downsells, both in the offline and the online world. In the online world, it tends to be more done for you, more help, more handholding and accountability than in the offline world. But it appears in both. So I think cross-sells and upsells are incredible and incredibly powerful in serving your people better. If that is your intention, if it's just about making money, guess what? People can see through that. If it's about really helping them to solve their problems, reduce their pain points, make things easier for them, then it's a good thing. So talking about those things today. That's all I've got today. I am doing an online event. I'm not doing one. I'm participating in one for this week. And so that is keeping me quite busy and quite entertained as well. Some of my favorite people in the world are participating in this event. So I love participating in it. If I can help you in any way, you know what to do. Hit me up. You can Voxer me at pajamagramma, G-R-A-M-M-A at gmail.com. That is a secret way to get a hold of me if you really want to get a hold of me quickly and get directly to me. Otherwise, you can always direct message me. That's it. Have an awesome day. If I can help you, ask. Otherwise, I will, of course, be with you tomorrow.